Mr. Okwiri George. He comes from Otuke District in Lango sub-county. George, can you briefly tell us what kind of shocks and stresses the people in your community are prone to?
Yeah, thank you very much, Madam Chair. I think let me start by correcting. Lango is not a sub-county. Lango is not a sub-region. So Otuke is one of the districts which was carved out of the former Lira district, which is in Lango sub-region. For those who don't know the geography of Uganda very well, or visitors, this sub-region is in northern Uganda, northeastern Uganda actually, because we border Karamoja region. Madam Chair, while Bududa was experiencing landslide in the 2009-2010, the same rain was causing extensive floods in the flat area of Lango sub-region, and Otuke in particular. And during those floods, the community experienced massive crop destruction, destruction of homesteads, destruction of infrastructure like roads, schools, and there was interruption of human activities because you couldn't hardly do anything. So when the floods ended, the after effect was actually very great famine. There was no food. Ladies and gentlemen, you agree with me that the mode of production of food crops in northern Uganda is not like this one in central Uganda. For us, we grow crops which we eat on a yearly basis. Millet grows in a season and it goes. Sipsim grows in a season and it goes, unlike matoke, unlike this and that. So when a disaster comes, which affects cultivation activities, the immediate after effect is famine. So in 2010-2011, Lango sub-region and Otuke in particular, experience a lot of famine, and this caused loss of life, and etc. loss of animals, and so forth. So that was the great experience which we had recently, as far as disaster is concerned. Thank you.
Judge, is famine a regular occurrence, or it is a once in a while occurrence?
Well, the floods are not regular, but the occurrence of food insecurity is very regular. Right now, at this particular time when we are speaking, in June and July, for those who know and who are here, we have a period called Odoen. Odoen is that period when there is very little food, and normally it's around this time when people are busy cultivating, the food stocks which were there last year are now depleted. We are expecting fresh food supplies in the next harvest, which is in the next 1 or 2 months. So it makes food insecurity almost a regular thing, because the foodstuffs are not enough to go through. Because it's the same foodstuff now, which sometimes you could also resort to sell for cars, for medical purposes, for school fees, and the like.
Okay.
And Buddha was saying, same thing happens in Lango. The rural community have adapted almost a despair situation of despair. In a situation like this, you just find them just appealing to my authorities to come to their aid. But on, in some cases, the local leaders have gone in and tried to sanitize people through lads. People have been given seeds, they have been given sanitization trainings, so that first ripening crops can